What role do fingerprints play in our lives? Yes, detective movies give a clear answer to this question. But besides that, could fingerprints determine your character? I'll get into that a bit later. First, let's imagine that one day you woke up without them. How about gadgets? So you wake up in your bed and immediately pick up your phone. You notice that it somehow feels strange. You try to unlock it, but it doesn't respond to your finger. Okay, enter the password code. You scroll through the newsfeed, but you do it ineptly, as if you're using the touchscreen for the first time. You're trying to reply to a message, but the text is poorly typed and constantly gets messed up. This isn't exactly an emergency, but the feeling is rather strange. You get out of bed and open your laptop, which also won't unlock without a fingerprint. You've been using a computer for many years and have learned to type quickly. But this time, when you start to write a message, you can't feel your fingers interacting with the buttons. It's difficult to determine where one key ends and another begins, so you often press two at once. Your typing speed drops noticeably. Scientists have only recently found out that fingerprints serve a person as the main mechanism of touch. Without them, it'd be difficult for you to read information and interact with whatever you're touching or holding in your hands. Temperature. Next, you come into the kitchen to make breakfast. You try to break the eggs for an omelet, but do it clumsily and the whole yolk spreads. Everything is falling out of your hands. When taking a pinch of salt, you take too much and make your breakfast inedible. It seems like the burner isn't heating enough because your fingers don't feel the warmth above it. You touch it and burn yourself a bit. Yep, the day isn't getting off to a great start. A very sensitive temperature sensor is located on our palms. Remember that when you're sitting at a campfire in nature, you're constantly stretching out your hands in its direction. Also, in cold weather, you feel your hands freeze faster than the rest of your body. Sensitivity. After an unsuccessful breakfast, you go to the store to buy new shoes. You've chosen the ones you want, but you can't figure out what they feel like, either polyester, rubber, or fake leather. All these materials feel the same. Without prints, you can't fully enjoy the smoothness of silk, the rustle of wool, the softness of cotton. Then, when you try to pay for the sneakers, you can't use PayPal on the phone because it doesn't read your fingerprint. So, you decide to pay in cash.
Oh.
But it takes forever to get the money from your wallet, and you awkwardly count the required amount. Papillary patterns on the fingers play a very important role in the fine motor skills of the hands. Thanks to them, we can easily separate thin pages of paper from each other, type on a keyboard, get cards and money from our wallets, play the piano, guitar, etc. Try to do one of these with leather gloves. You'll notice the difference. Identification and uniqueness. Let's say you work in a large modern company, where the pass to the office is carried out using a fingerprint. Of course, no identification scanner will recognize you, and you'll be late for work. You need to prove to the guard that you really work here, and after that, you'll have to listen to a rebuke from the boss for running late. The fact is that every print of every person is unique. The probability that you'll meet someone with the same finger pattern as yours is 1 in 64 million. Even for twins with the same DNA, the prints vary. In the modern world, without fingerprints, you won't be able to obtain a passport, travel outside the borders of your country, and in some cases, get to work. Dactylography, a way of identifying a person by fingerprints, is used in many areas of life, not just in investigations. In supermarkets, you can use your finger to pay for purchases. Fingerprint scanners are installed instead of ordinary locks on houses, cars, and gadgets. In many secret government organizations, access to sensitive information can only be obtained through fingerprint scanning. Interestingly, humanity has known about the uniqueness of fingerprints for a long time. In ancient Babylon, about 2000 BCE, people left prints on clay tablets as a signature. Then, in the 5 to 7 centuries, they were used in China for the same purpose. But fingerprinting wasn't used for police investigations until 1902 in the UK. Simply put, fingerprints are the ID that nature has given you. Their pattern is formed in the womb and will never change throughout your life. Despite this, scientists have recorded rare cases when a person was born with absolutely smooth fingers, void of prints. Such cases in medicine are considered a manifestation of a rare genetic tendency. These people don't experience any health problems, but they have problems with records. In addition to fingerprints, people also have unique prints on their tongue and feet. And with cats and dogs, nose prints are unique. But the most interesting discovery regarding fingerprints has happened recently. Scientists have found that on objects touched by a specific person, there are special bacteria. And guess what? They're also unique. That is, a unique bacterium is born within each fingerprint. These bacteria live for several weeks, and with the analysis of their DNA, you can determine the identity of a person. But back to the hero of our story. Let's talk about touch. After your bad day, you go to meet a loved one. And only now do you understand the full value of your prints. Without them, you're deprived of a very important connection with other people, a tactile connection. Touch plays a big role in building social relationships. Remember, in early childhood, we held our parents' hands. When we get older, we touch the people we meet and love. And after that, we'll hold the hand of our own children. Without an effective, tangible connection, a person will feel quite lonely. The patterns on our fingers can also be an additional tool for reading information. An excellent testimony of this is massage therapists. Their fingers are like real scanners that can detect the slightest disturbances and changes in the patient's body. So, the day is drawing to a close, but the problems don't end there. You return home and find small calluses on your fingers. That's because normally, the patterned rib structure of the surface of the fingers doesn't allow fluid to accumulate, and therefore reduces the risk of blisters. But let's go a little deeper into palmistry and try to determine the character of a person using the patterns on their fingers. Each fingerprint is unique, but nevertheless, there are only three main types of patterns for them: an arch, loops, and a whorl. You can leave fingerprints on a white sheet of paper or carefully examine each finger. Usually, there are two or three types of prints on a person. It's very rare for all fingers to have only one type. Count which patterns you have more of. The first type is the arch. People with these prints are very responsible, calm, and balanced. They don't get mad easily. They're excellent strategic and team players. Hardworking and reliable, they make friends easily and are family-oriented. The next type is the loop. People with this pattern on their fingers put self-expression and self-development in first place, even if it doesn't bring material benefits. Prone to mental work and risk, they're very energetic and creative people. And the last type is the whorl. The predominance of whorls speaks of well-developed logical and analytical thinking. People with this pattern are better at learning new languages and math. If all your fingers have whorls, you can consider yourself a genius. Such prints are mainly found among genius inventors and scientists. And finally, about the person born with no fingerprints, sometimes you can hear them singing hopefully, "Someday my prince will come." No, I made that up. Just can't help myself. Hey, if you learned something new today, then give the video a like and share it with a friend. And here are some other cool videos I think you'll enjoy. Just click to the left or right. And remember, stay on the bright side of life.